The last part in Unit 2 covers a single topic, how big is an atom? And you're not going to have to, like, use this formula, but if we were want to know how big an atom was, we would start with what's the center of an atom? We start with letter N. That's, of course, the nucleus. And then inside the nucleus we have, inside the nucleus we have what? Protons and neutrons. And then outside the nucleus we have what? Electrons. And I'll just go ahead and put a few out here. Let's put 4 electrons outside that nucleus. So I hope I kind of put a little bit of perspective on it, but this distance between the nucleus and the outside of the electron cloud is very large. I think I gave the example of a BB, the size of a nucleus, and then scale up the electrons then would be a 10-story building. So the nucleus in the center of the building. So my point here is that when it comes time for the volume of an atom, we are going to actually kind of look at what the electrons are doing as they create what we call that electron cloud outside the nucleus. And then this formula, like I said, you're not going to have to do this, but if you wanted to know the volume of a sphere, what you would do is to take the radius, this is the r, oops, some lowercase r, the radius raised to the 3rd power cubed times pi times 4/3. So again, you're not gonna have to come up with the volume of an atom like that, but that's how we could do it, or that's how we do it.